Okay, so Miss Shay here is getting her final groom before she gets to go to her hopefully new guardian home. They're gonna take her tomorrow and try it out. So what we're gonna do is she did just get a bath yesterday, and her hair is quite long. She's got the hair texture where we can go ahead and cut it today. It doesn't have to be like the fresh, like bathe, blow dry cut. For it to look good, because she has more of the wiry type hair. So we'll go ahead and cut her, trim up the feet, do the nails, and trim up the face, and then we are good to go. All right, so I'm using the Andes 2-speed, and for her body, I wonder, we're gonna do this, and but it is the 2-guard. If you can see that, it's the 2. So we put this on. This is connected to my shop vac. It's gonna be loud. All right, so we got the body shaved. And what we do is I like to go right above the Adam's apple, shave back up underneath the ears and kind of to a point. And then what I will do is I'll blend this in to, you know, the same length. But next, we went over the whole body, you know, all the way that the grain of the hair grows. She does have some swirlies, but you just want to go top, just the tip of the tail when you come here. You do start doing this, you go down that way and it won't leave you lines and then down. So the next thing is I took the guard off is we've got to get all this stuff. So I will actually do this one with a different set of clippers so it's not as loud. All right, so these are actually wall clippers. I just got these and I do really like them. They're sharper, so they, it is adjustable, but I do it to the shortest and you get a lot closer this way. So I always put my thumb right where the base of that pad is, go over top of my thumb. And then just go around. You just wanna make sure that you don't get too far up here because we've got to blend that in. This is just the underneath of the pads. You don't push hard because it is a blade and you don't want to cut none of that. And some dogs are ticklish, so they might fight. But we got to make sure we get all that out. It'll keep us a cleaner house and they don't slip. They've got better footing. And I do like to, which I've already done last time, which was a couple weeks ago, but I do like to keep the bottom part of their tummy where hair is not long down there because there's, it, you know, movement back and forth. We don't want to cause any little tangles and we want to keep it clean. Same with this one. Being a good girl, Shay. and then the private part. I've got a steady hand because I'm so used to doing this. So you're not going to push this directly to the skin. I'm holding out how far I think. So you might want to use it with a guard if you're not used to that, because you don't want to go directly to the skin. For one, for looks, and for two, it can irritate their bottom and their private part. But we definitely want to make sure that all of that doesn't have hair, so poop doesn't get stuck, and our pee-pee area, we can get UTIs if the hair is too long and we've got pee sticking there. Just got to make sure to keep that clean. They definitely need to be able to walk on, you know, if you've got hardwoods or tile, and not be slipping everywhere. And again, it'll help not have moisture in that area too, so lessen the chance of any types of infections in between the pads. All right, so next, now these, I wanted to show you these. These are my old, well, what I started grooming with was really nice, expensive. I went to a grooming program. I forget what it's called, but it's in Georgia, and I can put their website down, but they have a grooming expo with stuff for cheaper. And I did get these three and this and a comb for like $275. And that's a really good price. I do like to keep these, so I'll show you, but I've not really used these anymore. I only have those for backup, because I have a new set, and I'll discuss that one too, which is the Good Pup. The Good Pup is one of my, I've did a video on this before, but the Good Pup is, they have a couple different kits together with grooming. You can just get, you know, the scissors if you wanted. You know, the nail clippers, or you can get, you know, a medium pack that has a couple, you know, a couple more things, and then get the full pack, which again, I'll put their link at the bottom so you can see that too. But I really recommend those, especially if you're. All right. So next, now these, I wanted to show you these. These are my old, well, what I started grooming with, was really nice, expensive. I went to a grooming program. I forget what it's called, but it's in Georgia, and I can put their website down, but they have a grooming expo with stuff for cheaper. And I did get these three and this and a comb for like $275. And that's a really good price. I do like to keep these, so I'll show you, but I've not really used these anymore. I only have those for backup because I have a new set, and I'll discuss that one too, which is the Good Pup. The Good Pup is one of my, I've did a video on this before, but the Good Pup is, they have a couple different kits together with grooming. You can just get, you know, the scissors if you wanted, you know, the nail clippers, or you can get, you know, a medium pack that has a couple, you know, a couple more things, and then get the full pack, which again, I'll put their link at the bottom so you can see that too. But I really recommend those, especially if you're starting out with wanting to, you know, groom your dog. So that's just, it's perfect. So we'll start with around the feet. So you'll see that these are curved. So, and think of these being curved, and you're going to go around the foot in the curved look. So of course, where the nails are, you gotta make sure that if there's any hair sticking in there, that you pull those out so you can trim them. But you definitely wanna just cut the shape of the foot. You wanna make sure you don't cut it too far up, because then your feet won't be covered. You know, the toenails will show and all of that stuff. But if there's any bulkiness, you do wanna kind of trim those down. Hold on, Shay. Also, if you buy the Good Pup Kit, she has a whole grooming line of videos that she had professionally done that shows you how to use her products. So I would definitely look into that too. All right, so you see our groomed foot compared to our scraggly foot. Trimmed, I should say. You good girl, Shay? You're a little ticklish on your feet, though. And then, if you've got any scraggly ones that you want to make sure that you don't cut too much of a chunk, if you can see, this is a little thick for me, so I would just go in with the blenders and just go over top of that, just real thin, and blend that part down. And any other part that you can see that might need it. Some dogs too, excuse me, depending on like their elbows and stuff, hers isn't bad, but if they've got thick hair, you know, like this right here, I want to cut. Just always remember that whatever you're cutting, you need to know what's underneath of it. So like here, there's that pad. I know I can't cut it the full length of right here. You've got to make sure that you know that pad's there because you don't want to clip it. All right, now on to the back feet. We're just cutting the shape of the foot. Not too high up. Just trimming it up to be a good, clean, pretty look. Take my blenders and blend the top of the toes a little because I feel like they're sticking up too much. So there's the groom foot and the knot. Let's go twist it around. Here's the girl, Shay. Alright, so we're gonna cut the shape of the foot. I got the shape cut, but I got some thick spots, so I'm going to go in with the blenders and try to take out the thin spriggies so it all lays flat. Looks pretty good. All right, and then her tail. I did notice that it's trying to look a little spriggy. I didn't trim it last time, but we don't want it to look stringy. So this is what I'm gonna do. It's just cut off. You want it to look thick and full. So that definitely looks better. All right. Last but not least, we're gonna do the head. All right, sit. Good girl. So Miss Shay's face isn't too bad, but we definitely need to trim it up some. Like I said, I like to use these, especially on my puppies, and it's called the Gator from the company. I'll also put that below. But these, to buy brand new, are like $75 just for these. I like these on my puppies, but you don't have to do it for, you know, older dogs. I'm just used to them with my hands. So I'm going to try to just use this so you can see how the good pup works. So what you want to do is obviously make sure everything's cleaned up. And then if you can already see where it's grown out, it's like a triangle here. So we don't want that to show. So as it's grown out, it's shown. So what you want to do is you want to take the blade part, and that's what's going to go to the face. And then the teeth are up. So, and you have to make sure that your dog is good, not going to be throwing their head around, because they are rounded tips, but it still can get them. So you got to be careful. But I like to go right here, push that hair down, and just clean it up some, just to give us a straight line. And then when it comes to this other side, I know some breeders that do it this way. I can't do that, so I have to put my hand over. And do it that way. Now, sometimes it will get a little bit shorter on that side. It's just the way my hand does, it does that. So I'll do this other side to fix it. And then since it does have the rounded tips, you can go in and do this. And it's going to thin it out. But what you want to do is you're wanting to, again, keep this at a point going up. So you wouldn't want to do it really short right here and, you know, down far this way, because we still need it to be a point. But I definitely want to thin it out to where it's not any thicker. It looks just like it runs straight up the face natural. That's just the look that I like. All right, it's definitely looking better. All right, so we've pretty much got in between the eyes down as much as I think needs to be. I might touch it up a little. All right, so we've got the eyebrows. Now, since she is a phantom, I do want to keep that look. So, but we need to, I like it to look thin, 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 and then go over. So we'll thin it this way. So I don't want it too heavy. And then same with this side, but the opposite. And then once I thin down the color part, because that's kind of what you got to get, definitely to look the same first, is to, you can take a brush, of course, she doesn't have any tangles, so I've already brushed her. But you can take the brush and brush all the hair forward. And then I just go ahead and take the curve, just because I like the curve. But bring them all forward. You don't have to hold it down, but kind of hold their head at an angle. And then cut this like that. Again, you got to make sure that they hold their head still. So it's almost like putting a bowl on their head, but that's just for the front shape. And then shake it out, you know, blend it. So at this point, I feel like the top of her head is too thick, and we do want it to kind of blend down to her ears. So I kind of part it in the middle, because that's how I like the cut to be. And then I take the blenders and blend from the center. Usually I like to start, you know, it getting about short a little bit, since where it lays over, start here and then just blend it down to where it's kind of more flat, where it blends in. So can you see the difference? She's not pulling those ears out. Of the two sides? Kind of. So what I'll do is I'll come back on this side. Again, I don't switch hands because I'm right-handed. You can also come from the back and take up like that and try to get both sides even. You don't want to do too short though, because when it falls over the ears, you don't want it to be such an abrupt cut. You're a good girl, Shay. All right, before I go any further, I'm going to take my curved scissors again. And I push the head down to get it straight. And then I take this part and I start blending it into the head or the back of the nape of the neck. Now I'm just cutting the bulk part off because then I am going to go back with my blenders and help blend it together. But blenders, it's gonna, obviously it doesn't cut it all at one time. So you wanna get the bulk off first and then blend the rest in. And whatever look you like, I like a dog with a sleek neck. So I do come up, you know, pretty high in the back, but I blend it in so it doesn't look like the head's really big. But it's blended. But I definitely like a sleek neck. I don't want them to look like they have a fat neck. Nobody wants to look fat, huh? No, not if we can help it with a haircut. All right. All right, so I haven't touched the front yet. I'll still do a little bit to the top, but the front, what I like to do is definitely starting to look a little bit long. Remember, there are lips under there. So, but you comb that hair down, and I know that that much is going to be probably what I take off for her. So what you're going to want to do is come kind of at an angle, then down, then kind of go back up here. Think of where that ear lays, and you know, you're not gonna see underneath of the ear, so go ahead and cut that hair off. And then, so this is the top of the lip, and then here's the beard. So I do wanna blend that in too. So you see how it kind of angles down and then back up. You're a good girl, Shay. And try to get the other side to match. And I cut it a little shorter on that side, so I'm gonna go back on this side and try to make it look the same. One thing that I've learned, if you end up cutting it too short on one side and you don't like it, then don't blend the other side. If you take pictures a lot, you could always take good side pictures. But you know, don't match it, and then within a week or two, it should grow back out to where you could fix the other side. Okay, keep looking at me, Shay. Good again, where the underneath of that ear is, we're wanting to cut the majority of that hair out. So definitely want to thin out, well, trim this side just a little bit more. Alright, so we're almost done. The top doesn't look quite even yet, so we're still going to work on that. Her hair doesn't exactly part straight down the middle. She kind of got some cowlicks in there, so we got to work with that. See our piece that sticks up. So we're gonna let it do what it wants to. Just try to make it pretty close to the same length. And if you need to, it's just like people hair. If something isn't laying correctly, you can, you know, wet it down a little bit and then use the blow dryer on it and let it go in whatever direction it needs to for you. We might have to do that. We'll see at the end. All right, and then her ears flip out. You see how they do that? They've always done that. So what we're gonna do is we let it happen, but we just trim up. If you can see this right here, we just pretty much trim the line of her ear. But we don't take off all the length because she does have small ears. So we take the ear, kind of pull that back. Just cut some of it. And it's just to clean it up. Because we want it to look clean and have a crisp edge on it. So I definitely like the look of this ear compared to this. See how I feel like that looks a little scraggly. We got this ear that looks clean. So we will try to match the other side. You're a pretty girl. All right, then I think a little bit, I'm going to trim this right here a teeny bit. Let's see. Yeah, and on that side a little bit too. I'm just going to trim it just a tad. So, again, so it has like a crisp margin. So wait. Right. So last thing I can see is that maybe the back of the neck isn't even on one side. So So I'm gonna blend that up. Last but not least, we will do the nails. All right, so we've got the Good Pup nail clippers. Some people like to use this guard on the back. I'd rather not, and I need to undo them some so I can move them over. But that's just to help you so you don't go too far. But I've done this for years, so I'd rather not have a limit. But what we're going to do is, I don't know if you can see, her nails are black. We'll do show you on one that I haven't cut yet. So you can see where the bottom of the nail right here has, where it's opened up. I would go just a little bit before that. So, a little bit more. That's about the length I would do for her. It probably could go back just a tiny bit more, but I don't want to take the chance of quickening her. But that's pretty good. Oh, baby, hold on. Stay. Hey. I know your feet are ticklish. I know you're ticklish. Shay, no man. Now the breeder we got her from did not remove the dew claws. We don't either unless they're rear. So you always have to remember that there's a thumb on the front. So if you don't, that is one of the nails that if you forget about it or your groomer forgets about it and like a couple appointments go by, it can curve like this and start growing into the base of the arm. We definitely don't want that. I've seen a lot of those working at the vet. These are such easy clippers, though. I do love them. Super easy to work. We're done with the front, on to the back. The back nails usually don't tend to grow as long, so be careful, don't cut so much like you're thinking that you're doing the front again. So they tend to be shorter. Good girl. If you can see, I'm clipping the base of it, and then I go from side to side. It's like shaving the sides down, and it doesn't make them sharp. They don't have sharp nails because it's round in the whole nail. So, like, If you see here, I'm gonna take the majority, well, let's do a little bit more, the majority off, and then I'm gonna go on the side. It's gonna be angled on just the left side. And then I'm gonna angle just the right side. And then again, the left a little. Yep, so now it's soft. It doesn't have that sharp spot on it. Just make sure that you practice, you know, with it longer. Don't do it too short, because you still can shave the side of and go into the quick. Or you can use a Dremel. I have one, but this is easier for me. Well, it's quicker for me because I'd have to clip them anyways. But, and then once you clip the majority off, then just take the Dremel and round it up. But that's it. All right, have a seat for us. What do you think? Are you ready to go to your new home? Makes mommy sad, yeah? That's all right though, it's gonna be a good home. So now what we're gonna do is let her down, let her shake all around and take a peek at her to see if there's anything else that we wanna cut. She had a few whiskers, stop. A few whiskers sticking out. So trim those down. They are thicker, so they'll stick out above the hair. Shay's, yay! All right, that's Miss Shay's haircut.